How beautiful is the Princess Salome tonight?
You're always looking at her. You look at her too much. It is dangerous to look at people in such a fashion. Something terrible may happen.
How pale the princess is. Never have I seen her so pale. She's like the shadow of a white rose in a mirror of silver.
After me shall come another mightier than I. I am not worthy so much as to unloose the latchet of his shoes. When he cometh, the solitary places shall be glad. They shall blossom like the lily. The eyes of the blind shall see the day, and the ears of the deaf shall be opened. The newborn child shall put his hand upon the dragon's lair. He shall lead the lions by their manes.
Who is he?
A prophet.
What is his name?
Jochanan.
Whence comes he?
From the desert, where he fed on locusts and wild honey. He was clothed in camel's hair, and round his loins he had a leathern belt. He was very terrible to look upon. A great multitude used to follow him. He even had disciples.
What is he talking of?
We can never tell. Sometimes he says terrible things, but it is impossible to understand what he says.
May one see him?
No, the Tetrarch has forbidden it. The princess rises. She's leaving the table. She looks very troubled. Ah, she's coming this way. Yes, she's coming toward us. How pale she is. Never have I seen her so pale.
Do not look at her. I pray you not to look at her.
She's like the dove that has strayed. She's like a narcissus trembling in the wind. She's like a silver flower.
I will not stay. I cannot stay. Why does a tetrarch look at me all the while with his mole's eyes under his shaking eyelids? It is strange that the husband of my mother looks at me like that. I know not what it means. Ah, in truth, yes, I know it.
You have just left the feast, princess?
Ah, how sweet the air is here. I can breathe here. Within, there are Jews from Jerusalem who are tearing each other in pieces over their foolish ceremonies, and barbarians who drink and spill their wine on the pavement, and Greeks from Smyrna with painted eyes and painted cheeks and frizzed hair curled in twisted coils, and silent, subtle Egyptians with long nails of jade and russet cloaks, and Romans brutal with their uncouth jargon. Oh, how I loathe the Romans. They are rough and common, and they give themselves the airs of noble lords.
Will you be seated, princess?
Why do you speak to her? Why do you look at her? Oh, something terrible will happen.
How good to see the moon. She's like a little piece of money. You would think she was a little silver flower.
The Lord hath come. The Son of Man hath come. The centaurs have hidden themselves in the rivers, and the sirens have left the rivers and are lying beneath the leaves of the forest.
Who is that who cried out?
The prophet, princess.
Ah, the prophet. He of whom the Tetrarch is afraid. He says terrible things about my mother, does he not?
We never understand what he says, princess.
Yes, he says terrible things about her. Is he an old man, this prophet?
Princess, it were better to return. Suffer me to lead you in.
This prophet, is he an old man?
No, princess, he is quite a young man. Though you cannot be sure, there are those who say he is Elias.
Oh, who is Elias?
A very ancient prophet of this country, princess.
Rejoice not thou, land of Palestine, because the rod of him who smote thee is broken. For from the seed of the serpent shall come forth a basilisk, and that which is born of it shall devour the birds.
What a strange voice. I would speak with him.
I fear it is impossible, princess. The Tetrarch does not wish anyone to speak with him. He has even forbidden the high priest to speak with him.
I desire to speak with him.
It is impossible, princess.
I will speak with him.
Would it not be better to return to the banquet?
Bring forth this prophet. How black it is down there.
It must be terrible to be in so black a pit. It is like a tomb.
Did you not hear me? Bring out the prophet. I wish to see him.
Princess, I beg you, do not require this of us.
You will do this thing for me, will you not, Narabov? You will do this thing for me. I have always been kind to you. You will do it for me. I would but look at this strange prophet. Men have talked so much of him. Often have I heard the Tetrarch talk of him. I think the Tetrarch is afraid of him. Are you, even you, also afraid of him, Narabov?
I fear him not, Princess. There is no man I fear. But the Tetrarch has formally forbidden that any man should raise the cover of this well.
Ah, you will do this thing for me, Narabov. And tomorrow, when I pass in my litter beneath the gateway of the idol cellars, I will let fall for you a little flower, a little green flower.
Princess, I cannot. I cannot.
You will do this for me, Narabov. You know that you will do this for me. And tomorrow, when I pass in my litter by the bridge of the idol buyers, I will look at you through the muslin veils. I will look at you, Narabov. It may be I will smile at you. Look at me, Narabov. Look at me. Ah, you know that you will do what I ask of you. You know it well. I know that you will do this thing.
Let the prophet come forth. The Princess Salome desires to see him.
Ah.
Oh, how strange the moon looks. You would think it was the hand of a dead woman who is seeking to cover herself with a shroud.
She has a strange look. She's like a little princess whose eyes are eyes of amber. Through the clouds of muslin, she's smiling like a little princess.
Where is he whose cup of abominations is now full? Where is he who in a robe of silver shall one day die in the face of all the people? Bid him come forth, that he may hear the voice of him who hath cried in the waste places and in the houses of kings.
Of whom is he speaking?
You can never tell, Princess.
Where is she who, having seen the images of men painted on the walls, the images of the Chaldeans limed in colors, gave herself up unto the lust of her eyes and sent ambassadors into Chaldea?
It is of my mother that he speaks.
Oh, no, Princess.
Yes, it is of my mother that he speaks.
Where is she who gave herself unto the captains of Assyria, who have baldrics on their loins and tiaras of diverse colors on their heads? Bid her rise up from the bed of her abominations, from the bed of her incestuousness, that she may hear the words of him who prepareth the way of the Lord, that she may repent her of her iniquities. Though she will never repent, but will stick fast in her abominations, bid her come, for the fan of the Lord is in his hand.
But he is terrible. He is terrible.
Do not stay here, Princess, I beseech you.
It is his eyes above all that are terrible. They're like black holes burned by torches in a Tyrian tapestry. They're like black caverns where dragons dwell. They're like the black caverns of Egypt in which the dragons make their lairs. They're like black lakes troubled by fantastic moons. Do you think he will speak again?
Do not stay here, Princess. I pray you, do not stay here.
Oh, how wasted he is. He's like a thin ivory statue. He's like a moonbeam, like a shaft of silver. His flesh must be cool like ivory. I would look closer at him.
No, no, Princess.
I must look at him closer.
Princess, Princess.
Who is this woman who is looking at me? Bid her be gone. It is not to her that I would speak.
I am Salome, daughter of Herodias, Princess of Judea.
Back, daughter of Babylon. Come not near the chosen of the Lord. Thy mother hath filled the earth with the wine of her iniquities, and the cry of her sins hath come up to the ears of the Lord.
Speak again, Yochanan. Thy voice is wine to me.
Princess, Princess, Princess!
Shh! Speak again. Speak again, Yochanan, and tell me what I must do.
Daughter of Sodom, come not near me. but cover thy face with a veil, and scatter ashes upon thine head, and get thee to the desert and seek out the Son of Man.
Who is he, the Son of Man? Is he as beautiful as thou art, Yohanan?
Get thee behind me. I hear in the palace the beating of the wings of the angel of death.
Princess, I beseech thee, go within.
Angel of the Lord God, what dost thou here with thy sword? Whom seekest thou in this foul palace? The day of him who shall die in a robe of silver has not yet come.
Yohanan.
Who speaketh?
Yohanan, I am amorous of thy body. Thy body is white, like the lilies of a field that a mower hath never mowed. Thy body is white like the snows that lie on the mountains, like the snows that lie on the mountains of Judea and come down into the valley. The roses in the garden of the Queen of Arabia are not so white as thy body. Neither the roses in the garden of the Queen of Arabia, the perfumed garden of spices of the Queen of Arabia, nor the feet of the dawn when they light on the leaves, nor the breast of the moon when she lies on the breast of the sea. There is nothing in the world so white as thy body. Let me touch thy body.
Daughter of Babylon.
Thy body is hideous. It is like the body of a leper. It is like a plastered wall where vipers have crawled, like a plastered wall where the scorpions have made their nest. It is like a whitened sepulcher full of loathsome things. It is horrible. Thy body is horrible. It is of thy hair that I am enamored, Yohanan. Thy hair is like clusters of grapes, like the clusters of black grapes that hang from the vine trees of Edom in the land of the Edomites. There is nothing in the world so black as thy hair. Let me touch thy hair.
Back, daughter of Sodom, touch me not. Profane not the temple of the Lord God.
Thy hair is horrible. It is covered with mire and dust. It is like a crown of thorns which they have placed on thy forehead. It is like a knot of black serpents writhing round thy neck. I love not thy hair. It is thy mouth that I desire, Yohanan. Thy mouth is like a band of scarlet on a tower of ivory. It is like the vermilion that the Moabites find in the mines of Moab, the vermilion that the kings take from them. It is like the bow of the king of the Persians that is painted with vermilion and is tipped with coral. There is nothing in the world so red as thy mouth. Let me kiss thy mouth.
Never, never, daughter of Babylon, daughter of Sodom, never.
I will kiss thy mouth, Yohanan. I will kiss thy mouth.
Princess, princess, thou who art like a garden of myrrh, thou who art the dove of all doves, look not at this man, look not at him. Do not speak such words to him, I cannot suffer them. Princess, princess, do not speak these things.
I will kiss thy mouth, Yohanan.
The young Syrian has slain himself. The young captain has slain himself. He has slain himself, who was my friend. I gave him a little box of perfumes and earrings wrought in silver. Now he has killed himself. Princess, the young captain has just killed himself.
Shh. Let me kiss thy mouth, Yohanan.
Art thou not afraid, daughter of Herodias? Did I not tell thee that I had heard in the palace the beatings of the wings of the angel of death? And hath he not come, the angel of death?
Let me kiss thy mouth.
Daughter of adultery, there is but one who can save thee. It is he of whom I spake. Go seek him. He is in a boat on the Sea of Galilee, and he talketh with his disciples. Kneel down on the shore of the sea, and call unto him by his name. When he cometh to thee, and to all who call on him he cometh, bow thyself at his feet, and ask of him the remission of thy sins.
Let me kiss thy mouth.
Cursed be thou, daughter of an incestuous mother, be thou accursed.
I will kiss thy mouth, Yohanan.
I do not wish to look at thee. I will not look at thee. Thou art accursed, Salome. Thou art accursed.
I will kiss thy mouth, Yokanon. I will kiss thy mouth.
Where is Salome? Where is the princess? Why did she not return to the banquet? Ah, there she is.
You must not look at her. You are always looking at her.
The moon has a strange look tonight. Has she not a strange look? She's like a madwoman who's seeking everywhere for lovers. Oh, she's naked, too. She's quite naked. The clouds are seeking to clothe her nakedness, but she will not let them. She shows herself naked in the sky. She reels through the clouds like a drunken woman. I'm sure she's looking for lovers. Does she not reel like a drunken woman? She's like a madwoman, is she not?
No. The moon is like the moon, that is all. Let us go within. You have nothing to do here.
I will stay here. Manasse, lay the carpets there. Light torches. Bring forth the ivory tables and the tables of jasper. Ah, the air here is delicious. I will drink more wine with my guests. We must all show honors to the ambassadors of Caesar.
Ah, it is not because of them that you remain.
Yes, yes, the air is delicious. Come, Herodias, our guests await us. Oh, I've slipped. I've slipped in blood. It's an ill omen. It's a very ill omen. Wherefore is there blood here? And this body? What does this body here? Think you I am like the king of Egypt who gives no feast to his guests but that he shows them a corpse? Whose is it? I will not look on it.
It is our captain, sire. He is the young Syrian whom you made captain only 3 days ago.
I gave no order that he should be slain.
He killed himself, sire.
Oh? For what reason? I had made him captain.
We do not know, sire. But he killed himself.
That seems strange to me. It's ridiculous to kill oneself. It's strange that the young Syrian has killed himself. I'm sorry he killed himself. I'm very sorry, for he was fair to look upon. He was even very fair. He had a very languorous eye. I remember that I saw the way he looked languorously at Salome. Truly, I thought he looked too much at her.
There are others who look at her too much.
His father was a king. I drove him from his kingdom. And you made a slave of his mother, who was a queen, Herodias. So he was here as my guest, as it were, and for that reason I made him my captain. Oh, I'm sorry he's dead. Hold there. Why have you left the body here? I will not look at it. Away with it. It's cold here. There's a wind blowing. Is there not a wind blowing?
No, there is no wind.
I tell you, there is a wind that blows. And I hear in the air, I hear something that is like the beating of wings, like the beating of vast wings. Do you hear it?
I hear nothing.
I hear it no longer. But I heard it. It was the blowing of the wind, no doubt. Oh, well, it's passed away. No, I hear it again. Now, do you not hear it? It is just like the beating of wings.
I tell you, there is nothing. You are ill. Let us go within.
I am not ill. It is your daughter who is sick. She has the mien of a sick person. Never have I seen her so pale.
I have told you not to look at her.
Pour me forth wine. Salome, come, drink a little wine with me. I have here a wine that is exquisite. Caesar himself sent it to me. Dip into it thy little red lips, that I may drain the cup.
I am not thirsty, Tetrarch.
You hear how she answers me, this daughter of yours?
She does right. Why are you always gazing at her?
Bring me ripe fruits. Salome, come and eat fruit with me. I love to see in a fruit the mark of thy little teeth.
bite but a little of this fruit, and then I will eat what is left.
I am not hungry, Tetrarch.
You see how you have brought up this daughter of yours?
My daughter and I come of a royal race. As for thee, thy father was a camel driver. He was also a robber.
Thou liest.
Oh, thou knowest well that it is true.
Salome, come and sit next to me. I will give thee the throne of thy mother.
I am not tired, Tetrarch.
Ah, you see what she thinks of you.
Bring me... What is it that I desire? I forget.
Ah, I remember.
Lo, the time is come. That which I foretold has come to pass, saith the Lord God. Lo, the day of which I spoke.
Bid him be silent. I will not listen to his voice. This man is forever vomiting insults against me.
He has said nothing against you. Besides, he is a very great prophet.
I do not believe in prophets. Can a man tell what will come to pass? No man knows it. Moreover, he is forever insulting me. But I think you are afraid of him. I know well that you are afraid of
him. I am not afraid of him. I am afraid of no man.
I tell you, you are afraid of him. If you are not afraid of him, why do you not deliver him to the Jews who for these 6 months past have been clamoring for him?
Enough on this subject. I have already given you my answer. I will not deliver him into their hands. He is a holy man. He is a man who has seen God. Yet there be some who say that this man is the prophet Elias.
So the day is come, the day of the Lord. And I hear upon the mountains the feet of him who shall be the savior of the world.
What does that mean? Caesar is not coming into Judea. Only yesterday I received letters from Rome. They contain nothing concerning this matter.
Ah, the wanton, the harlot. Ah, the daughter of Babylon with her golden eyes and her gilded eyelids. Thus saith the Lord God. Let there come up against her a multitude of men. Let the people take stones and stone her.
Command him to be silent.
Let the war captains pierce her with their swords. Let them crush her beneath their shields.
Oh, nay, but it is infamous.
It is thus that I will wipe out all wickedness from the earth, and that all women shall learn not to imitate her abominations.
You hear what he says against me? You allow him to revile your wife?
He did not speak your name.
Oh, what does that matter? You know well that it is I whom he seeks to revile, and I am your wife, am I not?
Ah, of a truth, dear and noble Herodias, you are my wife. And before that, you were the wife of my brother.
It was you who tore me from his arms.
Of a truth, I was stronger. But let us not talk of that matter. I do not desire to talk of it. It is the cause of the terrible words that the prophet has spoken. Peradventure, on account of it, a misfortune will come. Let us not speak of this matter. Oh, do you not see your daughter? How pale she is.
What is it to you if she be pale or not?
Never have I seen her so pale.
You must not look at her.
In that day, the sun shall become black like sackcloth of hair, and the moon shall become like blood, and the stars of the heaven shall fall upon the earth like ripe figs that fall from the fig tree, and the kings of the earth shall be afraid.
I should like to see that day of which he speaks. When the moon shall become like blood, and when the stars shall fall upon the earth like ripe figs. This prophet talks like a drunken man. But I cannot suffer the sound of his voice. I hate his voice. Command him to be silent.
I will not. I cannot understand what it is he saith. But it may be an omen.
I do not believe in omens. Speaks like a drunken man.
It well may be that he is drunk with the wine of God.
What wine is that? The wine of God. From what vineyards is it gathered? In what wine press may one find it? You are looking again at my daughter. You must not look at her.
Salome, dance for me.
I will not have her dance.
I have no desire to dance, Tetrarch.
Salome, daughter of Herodias, dance for me.
Let her alone.
I command thee to dance, Salome.
I will not dance, Tetrarch.
You see how she obeys you?
What is it to me whether she dances or not? It is not to me. Tonight, I am happy. I am exceedingly happy. Never have I been so happy. Wherefore should I not be happy? Caesar, who is lord of the world, who is lord of all things, loves me well, and he has just sent me most precious gifts. Also, he has promised me to summon to Rome the king of Cappadocia, who is my enemy. It may be that at Rome he will crucify him, for he is able to do all things that he wishes. Verily, Caesar is lord. Thus, you see, I have a right to be happy. There is nothing in the world that can mar my happiness.
He shall be seated on his throne. He shall be clothed in scarlet and purple. In his hand, he shall bear a golden cup full of his blasphemies. And the angel of the Lord shall smite him. He shall be eaten of worms.
You hear what he says about you. He says that you will be eaten of worms.
It is not of me that he speaks. He speaks never against me. It is of the king of Cappadocia that he speaks, the king of Cappadocia who is my enemy. It is he who shall be eaten of worms. It is not I. Never has he spoken a word against me, this prophet, save that I sinned in taking to wife the wife of my brother. It may be that he's right, for of a truth, you are sterile.
I am sterile. I? You say that. You that are ever looking at my daughter. You that would have her dance for your pleasure. It is absurd to say that. I have borne a child. You have gotten no child. No, not even from one of your slaves. It is you who are sterile, not I.
Peace, woman. I say that you are sterile. You have borne me no child. And the prophet says that our marriage is not a true marriage. He says that it is an incestuous marriage, a marriage that will bring evils. And I fear that he is right. I am sure that he is right. But it is not the moment to speak of such things. I would be happy at this moment. Of a truth, I am happy. There is nothing I lack.
I am glad you are of so fair a humor tonight. It is not your custom. But it is late. Let us go within. Do not forget that we hunt a sunrise. All honors must be shown to Caesar's ambassadors, must they not?
Salome, Salome, dance for me. I pray thee, dance for me. I'm sad tonight. Yes, I am passing sad tonight. When I came hither, I slipped in blood, which is an evil omen. And I heard... I'm sure I heard in the air a beating of wings. A beating of giant wings. I can't tell what they mean. I'm sad tonight. Therefore, dance for me. Dance for me, Salome, I beseech you. If you dance for me, you may ask of me what you will, and I will give it to you, even unto half of my kingdom.
Will you indeed give me whatsoever I shall ask, Tetrarch?
Do not dance, my daughter.
Everything, even unto half of my kingdom.
You swear it, Tetrarch.
I swear it, Salome.
Do not dance, my daughter.
By what will you swear, Tetrarch?
By my life, by my crown, by my gods. Whatsoever you desire, I will give it you, even to the half of my kingdom, if you will but dance for me. Oh, Salome, Salome, dance for me.
You have sworn, Tetrarch.
I have sworn.
All this I ask, even the half of your kingdom.
My daughter, do not dance.
Even to the half of my kingdom. Thou wilt be passing fair as a queen, Salome. If it please thee to ask for half of my kingdom, will she not be a fair queen? It is cold here. There's an icy wind. And I hear. Wherefore do I hear in the air this beating of wings? One might fancy a bird, a huge black bird that hovers over the terrace. Why can't I see it, this bird? Oh, the beat of its wings is terrible. It's a chill wind.
Nay. Nay, it's not cold. It's hot. I'm choking. Pour water on my hands. Give me snow to eat. Loosen my mantle. Quick, quick, loosen my mantle. Oh, nay, but leave it. Oh, it is my garland that hurts me, my garland of roses. The flowers are like fire. They burnt my forehead. I can breathe now. How red those petals are. They're like the stains of blood on the cloth. That does not matter. You must not find symbols in everything that you see. It makes life impossible. It were better to say that the stains of blood are as lovely as rose petals. It were better to say that... But we will not even speak of this. Now I am happy. I am passing happy. Have I not the right to be happy? Your daughter is going to dance for me. Will you not dance for me, Salome? You have promised to dance for me.
I will not have her dance.
I will dance for you, Tetrarch.
Ah, you hear what your daughter says? She's going to dance for me. You do well to dance for me, Salome. And when you have danced for me, forget not to ask of me whatsoever you wish. Whatsoever you wish, I will give it to you, even to the half of my kingdom. I have sworn it, have I not?
You have sworn it, Tetrarch.
And I have never broken my word. I am not one of those who break their oaths. I know not how to lie. I am the slave of my word, and my word is the word of a king. Oh, the king of Cappadocia always lies, but he is no true king. He is a coward. Also, he owes me money that he will not repay. He has insulted my ambassadors. He has spoken words that were wounding. But Caesar will crucify him when he comes to Rome. I'm sure that Caesar will crucify him, and if not, yet will he die being eaten of worms. The prophet has prophesied it. Well, wherefore dost thou tarry, Salome?
I am waiting until my slaves bring perfumes to me and the 7 veils and take off my sandals.
Ah, you're going to dance with naked feet as well. Your little feet will be like little white doves. They will be like little white flowers that dance under the trees. No. She's going to dance on blood. There's blood spilled on the ground. She must not dance on blood. It were an evil omen.
What is it to you if she dance on blood? Thou hast waded deep enough therein.
What is it to me? Oh, look at the moon. She's become red. She's become red. As blood. Ah, the prophet prophesied truly. He prophesied that the moon would become red as blood. Did he not prophesy it? All of you heard him. And now the moon has become red as blood. Do you not see it?
Oh, yes. I see it well. And the stars are falling like ripe figs, are they not? And the sun is becoming black like sackcloth of hair. And the kings of the earth are afraid. That at least one can see. The prophet, for once in his life, was right. The kings of the earth are afraid. Let us go within. You are sick. They say at Rome that you are mad. Let us go within, I tell you.
Who is this who cometh from Adam? Who is this who cometh from Basra, whose raiment is dyed with purple, who shineth in the beauty of his garments, who walketh mighty in his greatness? Wherefore is thy raiment stained with scarlet?
Let us go within. The voice of that man maddens me. I will not have my daughter dance while he is continually crying out. I will not have her dance while you look at her in this fashion. In a word, I will not have her dance.
Do not rise, my wife, my queen. It will avail thee nothing. I will not go within till she hath danced. Dance for me.
Do not dance, my daughter.
I am ready, Tetrarch.
Thank you.
Ah, wonderful. Wonderful. You see that she has danced for me, your daughter. Come near, Salome. Come near, that I may give you your reward. I pay the dancers well. I will pay thee royally. I will give thee whatsoever thy soul desireth. What wouldst thou have? Speak.
I would that they presently bring me in a silver charger.
In a silver charger? Yes, yes, in a silver charger. She's charming, is she not? What is it that you would have in a silver charger, O sweet and fair Salome? You who are fairer than all the daughters of Judea, what would you have them bring thee in a silver charger? Tell me, whatever it may be, they shall give it to you. My treasures belong to thee. What is it, Salome?
The head of Yochanan.
Ah, that is well said, my daughter.
No, no.
That is well said, my daughter.
No, no, Salome. Do not ask me that. Do not listen to your mother's voice. She is ever giving you evil counsel. Do not heed her.
I do not heed my mother. It is for mine own pleasure that I ask the head of Yochanan in a silver charger. You have sworn, Herod. Forget not that you have sworn an oath.
I know it. I have sworn before my gods. I know it well. But I pray you, Salome, ask of me something else. Ask of me the half of my kingdom, and I will give it to you. But ask me not what you have asked.
I ask of you the head of Yochanan.
No, no, I do not wish it.
You have sworn, Herod.
Yes, you have sworn. Everybody heard you. You swore it before everybody.
Be silent. It is not to you I speak.
My daughter has done well to ask the head of Yochanan. He has covered me with insults. He has said monstrous things against me. One can see that she loves her mother well. Do not yield, my daughter. He has sworn. He has sworn.
Come, Salome. Be reasonable. I have never been hard to you. I have ever loved you. It may be that I have loved you too much. Therefore, ask not this thing of me. It is a terrible thing, an awful thing to ask of me. Surely I think that you're jesting. The head of a man that is cut from his body is ill to look upon, is it not? It is not meet that the eyes of a virgin should look upon such a thing. What pleasure could you have in it? None, no, no, it's not what you desire. Hearken to me. I have an emerald, a great round emerald which Caesar's minions sent me. And if you look through this emerald, you can see things which happen at a great distance. Caesar himself carries such an emerald when he goes to the circus. But my emerald is larger. It is the largest emerald in the whole world. You would like that, would you not? Ask it of me, and I will give it to you.
I demand the head of Yochanan.
You are not listening. Suffer me to speak, Salome.
The head of Yochanan.
No. No, you would not have that. You say that to trouble me because I have looked at you all this evening. It is true, I have looked at you all this evening. Your beauty troubled me. Your beauty has grievously troubled me, and I have looked at you too much. But I will look at you no more. Neither of things nor of people should one look. Only in mirrors should one look, for mirrors do but show us masks. Oh, bring me wine, I thirst. Salome. Salome, let us be friends. Come now. What would I say? What was it? Oh, yes, yes, I remember. Salome. But come nearer to me. Come nearer. Salome, you know my white peacocks, my beautiful white peacocks that walk in the garden between the myrtles and tall cypress trees. Their beaks are gilded with gold, and the grains they eat are gilded with gold also. And their feet are stained with purple. And when they cry out, the rain comes. And the moon shows herself in the heavens when they spread their tails. Two by two they walk between the cypress trees and the black myrtles. And each has a slave to tend it. Sometimes they fly across the trees. And anon they crouch in the grass and round the lake. There are not in all this world birds so wonderful. There is no king in all the world who possesses such wonderful birds. I am sure that Caesar himself has no birds as fair as my birds. I will give you 50 of my peacocks. They will follow you whithersoever you go. And in the midst of them, you will be like the moon in the midst of a great white cloud. I will give them all to you. I have but 100. And in the whole world there is no king who has peacocks like unto my peacocks, but I will give them all to you. Only, Only you must loose me from my oath and not ask me that which you have asked me.
Give me the head of Yohanan.
Well said, my daughter. As for you, you are ridiculous with your peacocks.
Be silent. You cry out always. You cry out like a beast of prey. You must not. Your voice wearies me. Be silent, I say. Salome, think of what you're doing. This man comes perchance from God. He is a holy man. The finger of God has touched him. God has put into his mouth terrible words. In the palace, as in the desert, God is always with him. At least it's possible. One doesn't know. It's possible that God is for him and with him. Furthermore, if he died, some misfortune might happen to me. In any case, he said that the day he dies, a misfortune will happen to someone. That could only be to me. Remember, I slipped in blood when I entered. Also, I heard the beating of wings in the air, a beating of mighty wings. These are very evil omens. And there were others. I'm sure that there were others, though I did not see them. Well, Salome, you do not wish a misfortune to happen to me. You do not wish that. Listen to me, then.
Give me the head of your cousin.
You're not listening to me. Be calm. I must be calm. Quite calm. Listen. I have jewels hidden in this place. I have a collar of pearls set in four rows. They are like unto moons chained with rays of silver. They are like 50 moons caught in a golden net. On the ivory of her breast, a queen has worn it. Thou shalt be as fair as a queen when thou wearest it. I have amethyst of two kinds, one that is black like wine, one that is red like wine, which has been colored with water. I have topazes yellow as are the eyes of tigers, and topazes that are pink as the eyes of a wood pigeon, and green topazes that are as the eyes of cats. I have opals that burn always with an ice-like flame, opals that make sad men's minds, and are fearful of the shadows. I have onyxes like the eyeballs of a dead woman. I have moonstones that change when the moon changes and are wan when they see the sun. I have sapphires big like eggs and as blue flowers. The sea wanders within them, and the moon comes never to trouble the blue of their waves. I have chrysolites and beryls and chrysoprase and rubies. I have sardonyx and hyacinth stones and stones of chalcedony. And I will give them all to you all, and other things will I add to them. The king of the Indies has, but even now, sent me four fans fashioned from the feathers of parrots, and the king of Numidia, a garment of ostrich feathers. I have a crystal into which it is not lawful for woman to look, nor may young men behold it till they have been beaten with rods. In a coffer of Mecca, I have three wondrous turquoises, and he who wears them on his forehead can imagine things which are not, and he who carries them in his hand can make women sterile. These are great treasures above all price. They are treasures without price, but this is not all. In an ebony coffer, I have two cups of amber. They are like apples of gold. If an enemy pour poison into these cups, they become like an apple of silver. In a coffer encrusted with amber, I have sandals encrusted with glass. Oh, what desirest thou more than this, Salome? Tell me the thing that thou desirest, and I will give it thee. All that you ask, I will give thee, save one thing. I will give thee all that is mine, save one life. I will give thee the mantle of the high priest. I will give thee the veil of the sanctuary.
Give me the head of Yohanan.
No. Oh, let her be given what she asks. Of a truth, she is her mother's child. Who's taken my ring? There was a ring on my right hand. Who has drunk my wine? There was wine in my cup. It was full of wine. Someone has drunk it. Oh, surely some evil will befall someone. Wherefore did I give my oath? Kings ought never to pledge their word. If they keep it, it is terrible. And if they do not keep it, it is terrible.
My daughter has done well.
I am sure that some misfortune will happen.
There is no sound. I hear nothing. Why does he not cry out, this man? Oh, if any man sought to kill me, I would cry out. I would struggle. I would not suffer.
The head, Your Highness.
Thou wouldst not suffer me to kiss thy mouth, Yokanan. Well, I will kiss it now. I will bite it with my teeth as one bites a ripe fruit. Yes, I will kiss thy mouth, Yokanan. I said it. Did I not say it? I said it. I will kiss it now. Wherefore dost thou not look at me, Yokanan? Thine eyes that were so terrible, so full of rage and scorn, are shut now. Ah, Yokanan. Yokanan, thou art the only man that I have loved. All other men were hateful to me, but thou wert beautiful. Oh, how I loved thee. I love thee yet, Yokanan. I love thee only. I'm athirst for thy beauty. I'm hungry for thy body. Neither wine nor fruits can appease my desires. Oh, what shall I do now, Yokanan? Neither the floods nor the great waters can quench my passion. I was a princess, and thou didst scorn me. I was a virgin, and thou didst take my virginity from me. I was chaste, and thou didst fill my veins with fire. Oh, wherefore didst thou not look at me, Yokanan? If thou hadst looked at me, thou hadst loved me. Well, I know that thou wouldst have loved me. And the mystery of love is greater than the mystery of death. Love only should one consider.
She is monstrous. Done is a great crime. I am sure it was a crime against an unknown god.
I approve of what my daughter has done, and I will stay here now.
There speaks the incestuous wife. Come, I will not stay here. Come, I tell thee. Surely some terrible thing will befall. Manasseh, Issachar, Osias, put out the torches. I will not look at things, and I will not suffer things to look at me. Put out the torches. Hide the moon. Hide the stars. Let us hide ourselves in our palace, Herodias. I begin to be afraid.
Ah. I have kissed thy mouth, Yokanan. I have kissed thy mouth. There was a bitter taste on thy lips. Was it the taste of blood? But perchance it is a taste of love. They say that love hath a bitter taste. But what of that? What of that? I have kissed thy mouth, Yokanan.
Gods, kill that woman!